thefts from college campuses to Metro Transit. Trains, cell phone thefts we're talking about this morning becoming more and more common. Just this week, we told you about how Hennepin County is teaming up with AT&T to try to reduce the problem, and now the conversation has moved over to the state capitol. Naomi Peskovitz is there, and Naomi, lawmakers are talking about something called a kill switch.
Yeah, and Brad, first of all, we should let you know that it did pass through during today's hearing, but let's talk about how it would work. Say your cell phone is unfortunately stolen. Once it's gone from afar, you could turn it off, make it inoperable. Basically, it'd just be like a brick in the thieves' hands. Now, supporters say that this bill would stop what they call an epidemic. It's happened to you or someone you know. From your purse, your backpack, even right out of your hands, your cell phone, gone.
They call it an epidemic because it's growing and it's becoming more and more violent, causing more harm.
Across the country, one in three robberies involves a cell phone. The numbers are twice as bad around the U of M campus.
Predators presume rightly that students are carrying valuable cell phones.
U of M Police Chief Greg Hessness hopes the kill switches would kill the incentive for those thieves. All saved data would be erased, and the phone can't be reactivated unless it's by you.
All the other options have been tried. They've tried a database. That didn't work. The Chinese aren't following any databases. They've tried public education, and that only goes so far.
If passed, the law would hold phone makers and service companies responsible. But opponents say government regulation will never keep up. So to hackers, what's mandated today could be outdated by tomorrow. And Senator Amy Klobuchar has introduced this bill on a federal level. California, they are also considering it. But today was pretty important. We are the first state to actually have a hearing on kill switches, though it still would have to see two other committees before even going to the floor for a vote. Reporting live at the Capitol, Naomi Peskovitz, 5 Eyewitness News.
Still a ways to go, Naomi. Thanks. Of course, we'll continue to follow.